Thank you very much for joining us tonight. I'm Shannon Ogden.
And I'm Ann Trujillo. And two Colorado lawmakers want red light cameras gone,
now,
period.
Law enforcement say this is not just about money. Studies show they say that they are making our roads safer.
Well, tonight, Denver 7's Jennifer Kowaleski with a 360 doozy on all sides of this heated red light camera debate.
Red light cameras
eliminate fatal crashes.
They're to keep you safe.
That is a money grab.
Or just a moneymaker.
An argument that's a fairly tired argument.
Big brother watching.
Let's lay this out 360 style, starting at the state capitol, where there's been a years-long battle against red light cameras. This latest bill would have banned their use statewide, but it failed to make it out of committee. A crusade against Big Brother is one 360 view. These two Republican lawmakers also raise concerns over tickets showing up in the mail, with no real ability for drivers to make their case to an officer or explain what happened.
I just want to point to a common sense perspective.
Another perspective, Lieutenant Robert Rock. He runs Denver's traffic investigation unit and testified against the bill. Rock's 360 view is data doesn't lie. And the data shows Denver's four red light camera intersections are getting results.
Red light cameras help prevent some of the more serious crashes.
If you've driven here at 6th and Lincoln, you know Big Brother is watching and waiting for you to run a red light. Denver Public Works has a different view on this. They've found that these red light cameras have reduced crashes by 60% here and 70% of T-bone crashes, which are the most likely to be deadly.
But not all drivers are buying the safety card. Their view. They want Big Brother gone, no matter the cost.
I don't like photo radar. I feel attacked on the sly behind your back.
In the city of Littleton, the anti-Big Brother crowd has already won. 2 years ago, city leaders voted to get rid of Littleton's flashing red light cameras. Littleton's 360 view did a 180. Their study found the cameras weren't reducing crashes or making the city any money.
I think there's sort of a myth out there that these red light cameras are a cash cow. In Littleton's case, they have not been a cash cow.
They're right to make that decision for themselves.
While Lieutenant Rock may disagree with Littleton's take, he believes it should be up to local governments to decide what's best for their city. Another reason, he says, a statewide no red light camera ban won't work.
It should be up to the elected officials in Denver, and unless there is a consequence to violating that law, then we still have a dangerous situation.
The truth is, crashes are down in Denver. But is it because of the cameras? And is it really about safety? That's for you to decide.
If folks don't want to get a ticket, then don't run the red light and don't speed.
I don't think it's fair. But I guess they have to catch us criminals some way, right?
Certainly a lot of perspectives on this one. Now, another thing worth noting, 2 years ago, a bill to restrict red light cameras made it all the way to the governor's desk, but he vetoed it for the second year in a row, showing again that this debate has many sides. Now, if you have an opinion on this story, I want to hear from you. Send me an email or comment on my Facebook page. I'm Jennifer Kowaleski for Denver 7.